Families of Solutions, Level 1. The study of differential equations is in some respect similar to that of your Calculus 2 Integral Calculus course. As a refresher, recall that when you were evaluating an antiderivative or indefinite integral, we had to remember to include the constant C of integration. An antiderivative that contains the constant of integration represents an entire family of antiderivatives. One antiderivative for each unique value of the constant C. For example, if we were asked to find the antiderivative or indefinite integral of the quantity 3x squared minus 1 dx, we would obtain the following antiderivative, x cubed minus x plus c. This antiderivative represents a family of functions and is usually referred to as the general antiderivative of the function 3x squared minus 1. This general antiderivative represents the family of all antiderivatives of the function 3x squared minus 1. Notice that each antiderivative will differ by a constant. This means that the graphs of any two antiderivatives of the function 3x squared minus 1 are vertical translations of each other. If we were to graph the antiderivative with constant of integration equal to 0, we would obtain the following curve. In the same manner, if we let the constant of integration to be equal to 1, negative 1, 2, negative 2, 3, and negative 3, we would obtain the following curves. All of these curves represent the various antiderivatives of the function 3x squared minus 1. If you were to take the derivative of any of these curves, you would obtain the function 3x squared minus 1. As a result, these curves are all part of one happy family that can be represented by the general antiderivative x cubed minus x plus c. In this sense, an indefinite integral contains infinitely many antiderivatives, corresponding to the unlimited number of choices that the constant of integration c can attain. A similar concept exists when solving differential equations. For example, when solving first-order differential equations, we usually obtain a solution containing a single arbitrary constant, which we will call the parameter c. A solution containing an arbitrary constant represents a set of solutions called a one-parameter family of solutions. For example, the following function, y equals c times e to the power of x, represents a one-parameter family of solutions to the differential equation y prime minus y equals 0 on the interval negative infinity to positive infinity. It's a one-parameter family of solutions because it contains one constant, in this case, c. In general, when solving an nth-order differential equation, we seek an nth-parameter family of solutions. As a result, a single differential equation can possess an infinite number of solutions, corresponding to the unlimited number of choices for the parameters. As an additional example, the following function, y equals c sub 1 times e to the x plus c sub 2 times e raised to the power of negative x, represents a two-parameter family of solutions to the differential equation y double prime minus y equals 0. It's a two-parameter family of solutions because it contains two constants, c sub 1 and c sub 2. Now let's talk about the various types of solutions that exist when solving ODEs. A solution of a differential equation that is free of arbitrary parameters is called a particular solution. For example, if we were to take the one-parameter family of solutions y equals c times e to the x and assign values to the parameter c, we would obtain the following solution curve. If the parameter c equals 0, we would obtain the following graph. Notice that this graph represents the trivial solution y equals 0 to the differential equation y prime minus y equals 0. In the same manner, we would obtain the following graphs when c equals 1, negative 1, 2, negative 2, 3, and negative 3. Each of these graphs are particular solutions of the family y equals c times e to the x on the interval negative infinity to positive infinity. Keep in mind that a particular solution is free of arbitrary parameters. In the same manner, the two-parameter family of solutions also contains infinitely many particular solutions, such as the trivial solution y equals 0, when both C sub 1 and C sub 2 equals 0. Y equals e to the x when C sub 1 equals 1 and C sub 2 equals 0. The solution y equals e to the negative x when C sub 1 equals 0 and C sub 2 equals 1. The solution y equals 5 times e to the x minus 2 times e to the negative x when C sub 1 equals 5 and C sub 2 equals negative 2, and so on. A family of solutions containing n essential parameters is called a general solution, where n is the order of the differential equation. Roughly speaking, the solution of an nth order differential equation requires n integrations, and thus results in n parameters. For linear ODEs, every possible particular solution can be found by appropriate selection of parameters of the general solution. Thus, the general solution is also a complete solution. This is not the case for nonlinear ODEs. For nonlinear ODEs, with the exception of some first-order equations, are usually difficult or impossible to solve in terms of elementary functions. If we happen to find a family of solutions or general solution, it is not obvious whether this family contains all solutions. Because of the nature of nonlinear ODEs, a nonlinear differential equation often has a solution that cannot be obtained from the general solution. This solution is called a singular solution. For example, the solution y equals 2 over the square root of x plus c is a general solution of the differential equation 8 times y prime plus y cubed equals 0 on the interval negative c exclusive to positive infinity. Notice that the solution y equals 0 is also a solution of this differential equation. But y equals 0 can't be obtained by assigning a value to the parameter c from the general solution. This means that the solution y equals 0 is a singular solution of the nonlinear differential equation. Note that the solution y equals 0 is also a trivial solution of the differential equation. When dealing with nonlinear ODEs, be on the lookout for singular solutions that cannot be obtained from the general solution. They might be the trivial solution, but this is not always the case. Lastly, a solution to a differential equation can be a piecewise defined function. For example, the family y equals c times x squared is a general solution of the differential equation x times y prime minus 2y equals 0 on the interval negative infinity to positive infinity. Using the general solution, we can generate two particular solutions. The first is when we set the parameter c equal to 1, and the second is when we set the parameter c equal to negative 1. The solution curve of each graph is represented by the following curves. It turns out that we can actually construct a solution by using parts of each particular solution. We can essentially use the function y equals negative x squared from negative infinity to 0 exclusive. In other words, the values of x are less than 0. In combination with the function y equals x squared from 0 inclusive to positive infinity. In other words, the values of x are greater than or equal to 0. This piecewise defined function can be considered as a particular solution to the differential equation. Note that this piecewise defined function is different from both the solution y equals x squared and y equals negative x squared when looked at individually. Notice that this piecewise defined function cannot be obtained from the family y equals cx squared by a single choice of the parameter c. Rather, the solution is constructed from the family by choosing c equals negative 1 for x is less than 0 and c equals 1 for x is greater than or equal to 0. When constructing piecewise defined solutions of differential equations, the piecewise defined function must be differentiable and satisfy the differential equation at the given interval of definition, just like an explicit or implicit solution of a differential equation. Alright, to sum up, the process of solving differential equations yields solutions that contain arbitrary parameters. When solving an nth order differential equation, we seek an nth parameter family of solutions. A family of solutions containing n essential parameters is called a general solution. A solution of a differential equation that is free of arbitrary parameters is called a particular solution. A solution that can't be obtained by assigning a value to the parameter c in the general solution is referred to as a singular solution. And lastly, a solution to a differential equation can be a piecewise defined function, by restricting the domain of two or more particular solutions. Alright, in our next video, we will practice verifying family of solutions of differential equations.